देन कम टू दिस पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड, ओके पिट्यूटरी, और इट इज अदरवाइज नोन एज योर हाइपोफाइसिस, हाइपोफाइसिस, ओके। सो दिस हाइपोफाइसिस इट लोकेटेड एट द पिट्यूटरी फोसा, ओके। सो दिस इज योर व्हाट, पिट्यूटरी फोसा, और यू कैन से इट इज हाइपोफाइसिस फोसा, ओके, पिट्यूटरी फोसा, और यू कैन से हाइपोफाइशियल फोसा, ओके। सो देयर दिस पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड दैट सिचुएट्स, ओके। सो द लोकेशन ऑफ दिस पिट्यूटरी फोसा इज इनसाइड द, सॉरी पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड इज इनसाइड द पिट्यूटरी फोसा एंड दैट कनेक्टेड टू द हाइपोथैलेमस थ्रू द स्टॉक, ओके। सो दिस इज द स्टॉक ओवर हियर, राइट। सो दिस स्टॉक इज नोन एज योर, व्हाट इज दैट, पिट्यूटरी स्टॉक, पिट्यूटरी स्टॉक, ओके। सो और अदरवाइज ऑल्सो इट इज नोन एज द इनफंडिबुलम स्टॉक, ओके, इनफंडिबुलर स्टॉक, इनफंडिबुलर स्टॉक, राइट, ओके। एंड द फंक्शन ऑफ दिस पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड मेनली इट प्रोड्यूसेस द स्टिमुलेटिंग हार्मोन्स, ओके, इट विल प्रोड्यूस स्टिमुलेटिंग हार्मोन्स। हाइपोथैलेमस प्रोड्यूसेस, इधर इट विल प्रोड्यूस द रिलीजिंग हार्मोन और इट विल प्रोड्यूस द इनहिबिटिंग हार्मोन, ओके। लाइक दैट द पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड इट प्रोड्यूसेस द स्टिमुलेटिंग हार्मोन्स, ओके। सो दीज स्टिमुलेटिंग हार्मोन्स दैट एक्चुअली अफेक्ट द एंडोक्राइन ग्लैंड्स ऑफ ऑल ओवर द बॉडी, ओके। सो लाइक योर क्लासिक एग्जाम्पल इज योर TSH, राइट, थायराइड स्टिमुलेटिंग हार्मोन, ओके, दैट विल स्टिमुलेट टू योर व्हाट, योर थायराइड ग्लैंड, राइट। सो दिस पिट्यूटरी इट मेनली प्रोड्यूसेस द स्टिमुलेटिंग हार्मोन्स, ओके। सो नाउ वील सी what are these hormones that produces means that produces inside the pituitary gland, okay. So as you know that we have the adenohypophysis and we have the neurohypophysis, right. So this is what I am marking over here is the adenohypophysis, okay. This is your adenohypophysis. And posterior one is the neurohypophysis, okay. This is your neurohypophysis, right. So we'll see, okay, first we are just studying the a brief idea about all these things, okay. Detail we'll study later on, right. Just I am giving you the idea, right, okay. So here the hormones of adenohypophysis, first we will see what are the hormones that releases from the adenohypophysis, okay. What they are actually, the human growth hormone, okay, and they have the thyroid stimulating hormone, okay, and also it produces the follicle stimulating hormone, okay, FSH, है ना, it produces the luteinizing hormone, okay, and it produces the prolactin hormone, okay, and it also produces your ACTH, no, what is ACTH, adenocorticotropic hormone, okay, what produces, adenocorticotropic hormone, okay, ACTH, right, and also it produces the melanocyte stimulating hormones, okay. Already I have told you about these things, right. So these hormones, they are the stimulating hormones, right? Suppose here we will find the human growth hormone, right? That means this human growth hormone, that will only produce over here. This is only the stimulating hormone. So this hormone will stimulate the various body parts, okay, for the growth, okay. Then you will find the thyroid stimulating hormone. So when the thyroid stimulating hormone will reach at the thyroid gland, it will stimulate to the thyroid gland, and thyroid gland will produce whatever your hormones, again the T3, T4, something like that, right? That will produce there. So all these hormones, they are actually stimulating hormones. Okay, so they always stimulates to the targeted endocrine glands of all over the body, right? Okay, then we'll see that the hormones which actually releases from the neurohypophysis. Okay, from the neurohypophysis. What is that? You know, there are only two hormones that releases from the neurohypophysis. Okay, that is your oxytocin. Okay, and another one is your antidiuretic hormone. Okay, ADH. Okay, so these two hormones that produces here at the posterior part of the pituitary gland, or you can say it is the neurohypophysis. Fine. So now we'll see about the pineal gland. Okay. So here you can find one gland that already I have told you that it is present at the where? At the posterior to your thalamus. Okay. So if you'll find the thalamus over here, one thalamus over here, okay, and another thalamus over here, okay, and in front, what is that? What is this? This is the hypothalamus. Okay, this is your hypothalamus and this is the thalamus. Okay, this is the thalamus, right? Okay, so here at the posterior part of the thalamus, there will find the nucleus. So this nucleus is your habenular nucleus. Okay, this nucleus is known as your habenular nucleus. Okay, so in between these two habenular nucleus, there are the axons. Okay, the axons. Okay, what is this habenular nucleus? Means what? There is a group of cell bodies. No, so group of cell bodies are here, group of cell bodies are over here, and their axons are connecting to each other, right, like this. They are just exchanging the information with each other, right? So these fibers, okay, these fibers are known as your commissural fibers. Okay, so at this commissural fibers you will find a gland. So this gland is your pineal gland. Okay, so here you will find the pineal gland, right? So this pineal gland, its location present over here at the commissural fibers, but it just descends downward. Okay, this fundus part of the pineal gland, that actually descends downward. Okay, up to what it will descend? It will descend here. You can see, what is this thing? Who can say what is this thing? This is known as your superior colliculus. Okay, this is known as your superior. Okay, so the superior colliculus, that is present at the, what is this section? This is your midbrain. Okay, this is present in your midbrain, right? So the pineal gland, though it is present at the diencephalon, okay, so this whole system is your diencephalon. Okay, whole system is your diencephalon. Okay, so the pineal gland, though it is present at the diencephalon, but it will just hang out up to the, what is that, superior colliculus, right? So suppose you will see the midbrain from the back side, okay? So what we'll see, this is your midbrain, okay? And here you'll find the pons, and you'll find the medulla, right? And the spinal cord, right? So so this is the junction. This is a pons, this is medulla, this is spinal cord, and this is the midbrain. So if you'll see the midbrain at from the posterior end, you'll find there are two, right? P-like structures, okay? The protrusions that will be present over here, okay? So this two is known as your superior colliculus, okay? And these two is known as your inferior colliculus, okay? So this is superior colliculus and this is inferior colliculus, right? And just above to that will find diencephalon. That means here will find the habenular nucleus, the commissural fibers, okay? And from here the pineal gland is just coming like this, okay? This is what? Which view? It is the posterior view. Okay? So from the posterior view, the pineal gland is situated like this, okay? So this is your pineal gland. The pineal gland that is present in between the superior colliculi. Okay, colliculi means it is the plural. Okay, colliculus singular. And what is the function of this pineal gland? Who can say? It actually maintains the, or you can say it regulates. Yes. Who can say? Sleep.
Circadian rhythm.
Yes, sleep wake cycle. Circadian rhythm, right? Okay. And which hormone it releases?
Melatonin.
Very good. Melatonin. Okay, this is the thing. Then we'll see another, that is the thyroid gland. The pineal gland, this much is sufficient. Detail we are not studying. We are just, I am giving you a brief idea before entering to the endocrine system. Okay. Then we will see the thyroid gland. Right. So, the thyroid gland, where it is present? Thyroid gland. Thyroid gland that is present at the anterior part of the neck region. No. So, its location is anterior surface of neck. Okay, but that you know already, right? But why I have written here? Because you should know the exact location of the thyroid gland. Who can say what is the vertebral corresponding vertebral level to the thyroid gland? Okay, C5 to T1. Okay, remember, that means what? If you want to palpate the thyroid gland, right, then first you have to identify the C5 transverse vertebrae. Spinous process of the C5 is easily palpable, but just if you go 1 inch lateral to the spinous process, you will reach at the transverse process, and from that transverse process you may come anteriorly. Your finger should slide anteriorly to reach at the, what is that, upper margin of the thyroid gland, that is C5 region. Okay, then below to that you will find whatever the surface is there, that you can easily hold that thyroid gland to mobilize or whatever it is, right? So the location mainly that is present at the level of, what is that, C5 to T1 vertebral level. Okay, then the structure. Okay, so it has the lobes, right? What are the lobes? It has the left lobe, okay, It is the right lobe. It has the isthmus. Who can say what is this isthmus? Isthmus is the connector. Okay, the bridge between this right lobe to left lobe. Okay, so it is the connector between the lobes. Okay, that is known as the isthmus. Okay, right. Now we'll see the function. Okay, the function mainly it regulates the metabolism. Okay, it regulates metabolism. Okay, then what hormone it produces? It produces the thyroxine hormone. Okay, and it also produces, who can say, triiodothyronine. Okay, triiodothyronine, what will write? Tri, okay, triiodothyronine. Okay, this is the T3. Okay, and T4 is thyroxine. Okay, thyroxine hormone. And also it produces another hormone. Who can say another hormone? What is that hormone? Calcitonin. Right, calcitonin. Okay, you don't see my spelling mistake, huh? You just rectify it if I am making the spelling mistake, right? So the thyroid gland is present at the outer surface of the neck from the C5 to T1 level. It has three lobes mainly. The two lobes, that is the left lobe and the right lobe, and the connector between these two lobes is the isthmus. Okay. The function of this thyroid is it actually regulates the metabolism by enhancing it, and the hormones it produces, the T3 and T4. Okay, and also the calcitonin. Okay, so 1, 2, and 3 hormones it releases. Okay, so this is about the thyroid gland. Okay, then we'll see another gland. That is your parathyroid gland. Okay, parathyroid gland. Okay, so first, what is the location of this parathyroid gland? Who can say? See, if you will draw the thyroid gland. Okay, suppose this is your what is that, your right lobe, and this is your left lobe, and this is your isthmus, right? Just at the, suppose you are seeing from the posterior side. Okay, this is the posterior view. Okay, then you will find the parathyroid glands over here. Okay, at the posterior part of the posteriorly, you will find at the lobes of the thyroid gland. Okay, so the location is posteriorly to the lobes of thyroid gland. Okay, so at the posterior part of the lobes of the thyroid gland, you will find small, what is that, your nodules like structure that you will find at the thyroid gland. Okay, so that they are known as the parathyroid gland, right? Location. Then what is the function of this parathyroid gland? Okay, function. What is that function? Function of this? It actually regulates the calcium, right? Regulates calcium. Okay. So, by how? It actually regulates the blood levels of the calcium. Okay, inside the bloodstream. Okay, blood levels of calcium. Okay, by increasing it. Okay, right. So this is the function, mainly the parathyroid gland. Okay, and which hormone it releases? It releases parathyroid hormone. Simple. Parathyroid hormone. Okay. So this is the your what is that? Your parathyroid gland. Okay. Now you see another gland. That is what? Another gland. That is the okay. What is this gland? This gland is your pancreas, right? You will see the pancreas over here, and also you will see the gastric mucosa, right? Endocrine part of the endocrine part of pancreas, because pancreas has two functions, right? One is endocrine function, another is the what is that? Digestive function, right? So it also produces the digestive enzyme. It also produces the insulin, right? So the insulin, it is the part of your endocrine part of pancreas, right? So what there will find the cells, okay? Group cells you will find over here, okay? So these group cells are known as your what is that? Langerhans islets, okay, or you can say the islets, is no islets, is let islets of Langerhans, okay, HANS, HANS, islets of Langerhans, okay, so. This islets of Langerhans, that is actually the pancreatic tissue, okay, group of pancreatic tissue. They are the group of pancreatic tissue, okay. So this group of pancreatic tissue that produces the insulin, okay, and that regulates the insulin, okay. Along with that, you will find, suppose here is your digestive tract, okay. You know that already I have told you about the digestive tract. If this is the lumen of the tract, okay, this is the lumen of the tract, then here you will find that there are the columnar epitheliums, no, columnar epitheliums are there. So, these columnar epitheliums, they rest over the basement membrane, right? Basement membrane, right? So after this basement membrane, you'll find the muscularis mucosae. Okay, you'll find the muscularis mucosae. So this muscularis mucosae, basement membrane, or you can say the lamina propria. Okay, along with the cells. Okay, so these cells, this is your mucosal layer. Okay, this is your mucosal layer. Below to the mucosal layer, you will find the submucosal layer. Below to that, you will find the muscle layer. And below to that outer part, you will find the peritoneal layer, or you can say. Okay. So, at this mucosal layer, okay, at the mucosal layer of the gastric, or you can say okay, you just say it is the gastric mucosa. Okay, you say the gastric mucosa. Okay, so the gastric mucosa and the endocrine part of the pancreas, they actually act as a what is that? Your endocrine gland. Okay, and these gastric mucosa and the endocrine part of the pancreas, that is the islets of Langerhans, this and the gastric mucosa. Okay, two things. So these two tissues. Okay, what tissue? Endocrine tissue. If you see the function of this tissue, they actually, what is that? They regulates the blood in form of your glucose. Okay. Okay, so the function of this pancreatic tissue and the gastric mucosa. Okay, these two things, gastric mucosa. Okay, so what is the function? They regulates the blood level. Regulates the blood level of glucose. Which one? Mainly the pancreatic tissue. Okay, what is that? Islets of Langerhans. Okay, and this gastric mucosa, okay, it actually regulates the digestion. Okay, so these two function you will find in the pancreatic and the gastric mucosa. Then what hormones they actually releases? Who can say the hormones? The hormones released is by these tissues is your insulin, right? You'll find the glucagon. Okay, sorry, don't see my spelling mistake. Glucagon. Okay, then we'll find the gastrin. Okay, you'll find the secretin. Okay, you'll find the secretin, and also you'll find the ghrelin. Okay, and you'll find the motilin. Okay, and who can say other hormones? Anybody? Koli?
Cytokinin.
And I am forgetting always E. Okay, cholecystokinin. Another one is gastric. Okay, inhibitory polypeptide. Okay, so these hormones, okay, mainly these hormones, they are released by the islets of Langerhans and the gastric mucosa, right? So this is about your endocrine part of the pancreas and the gastric mucosa, right? So like that, you will find another gland. What is that gland? That is the adrenal gland. Okay, adrenal gland. You say glands, right? Okay, so this adrenal gland location, who can say? It is present at the
kidney above medulla.
superior pole of, sorry, superior pole of Sydney, right? Okay, then structure, it is the adrenal cortex, है ना, adrenal cortex, which mainly secretes what? Glucocorticoids, no? Which secretes glucocorticoids, okay? And also it secretes the mineral corticoids, right? Mineral corticoids, okay? And after this adrenal cortex, you will find the another, just deep to that, what you find? Adrenal medulla. You'll find the adrenal medulla. Okay. And this adrenal medulla, which secretes your biogen amines. Biogen. Is it okay? Biogen? Yes. Biogen amines. Okay. So, what is this function of this one? Okay, function, whatever it is, right? So, function of this, it actually regulates the blood pressure. Regulates blood pressure. Okay. And also it helps in maintaining the electrolyte. Okay, sorry, electrolyte balancing, balance, balance. Also, it helps in, what is that, stress response, stress response, clear? So, function of this, what is that, adrenal gland, mainly it regulates the blood pressure, it maintains the electrolyte in the inside the body, and it responds to the stress. Okay, stress response. Fine. Then the hormones which produced over here. What are these hormones? I told you about the glucocorticoids. Glucocorticoids. Okay, so these glucocorticoids, they release what? Cortisol. Okay, they release the cortisol, and also it releases the corticosterone, right? Corticosterone. Okay, cortisol, corticosterone. Okay, like that we got another, what is that, mineral corticoids, mineral corticoids. So these mineral corticoids, that actually releases which hormone, who can say? Aldosterone, right? Okay, which releases the, not E, aldosterone. Okay, aldosterone. And it also releases what? Biogen amine. Biogen amine. Okay, and so this biogen amine, that actually releases what? Two things. Who can say? What is that two things? You can say three things. What is that three things? Who can say? You have studied. epinephrine, okay, epinephrine, is it okay? Epinephrine, okay, epinephrine. Another is your non-epinephrine, epinephrine, okay. And another who can say? Last, biogenamines, they release the hormone, what the hormones? Epinephrine, norepinephrine, another is your? No, dopamine, okay, they release the dopamine, right. So, this is all about your adrenal gland. Then, after this adrenal gland, we will see the, what is that? Gonads. Okay. So, what is the function of these gonads? It regulates. Yes, it regulates sexual development. Okay. And the behavior, right? And the characteristic, okay, and also it regulates the gametogenesis, gametogenesis, okay. And the hormones, it depends upon the it depends upon the gonads, no? Hormones, it depends upon the gonads. Which gonad? If it is the testis or if it is the ovary, okay? So if it is the testis, then it will release the testosterone, okay, and ovary, it will be estrogen and progesterone, okay. So these two hormones that will be released from the your gonads, right. And this is all about your a brief idea about the endocrine system, okay. So if you see the clinical part, then either it will be your hyperfunction or it may have the hypofunction, okay, or it may have the adenoma, okay, or it may have the carcinoma. You see, very briefly I have told you, right? What is that? Clinical, if you will see the clinical, we'll study. Huh? Just I am giving you the idea, okay? So, the details we'll study. So, if you'll find a abnormalities of a gland, which gland? The endocrine gland, okay, that means either you will find the hyperfunction or you will find the hypofunction or you will find the adenoma or you will find the carcinoma. On the basis of these four things, okay, we will discuss the endocrine glands malfunction, okay, or the clinical aspect.